Kelly, I know I missed out tonight, royally. I know. And I truly am sorry.
You're the last person that I want to see in my face right now.
Look, I admit, inviting you to dinner to make Katie squirm, it was stupid. I mean, it was dumb. I didn't even know why I did it. And I understand if you're angry, even if you want to quit. But please, I feel awful if I hurt you.
Let's just call it a night. Okay,
shall we? I don't want to. I feel awful. Please, tell me how I can make it up to you.
What I really want is for you to go.
And leave you here all alone to brood in the darkness because I acted like a complete jackass. I can't. So one more time, with feeling, I am sorry. Wow, neat trick. So that means you must accept my apology then.
Carly, I reset the fuses and smoke alarm. Listen, I gotta apologize. Simon, wow. I mean, come on, haven't you caused Carly enough trouble? Please, buddy, just go.
I will, Jack, I will, if that's what Carly wants.
Looking for the combination to my safe. It's the same as my birthday.
Oh, don't worry, I'm not after cash, jewels, or bond certificates.
Then might I again inquire?
I'm pathologically wide awake after my blowout with grandmother. I really hate confrontations.
Sometimes they can't be avoided.
So instead of tossing and turning, I thought I'd go out. I was just looking for something to write a note with.
There's a pen right there in plain sight.
Yeah, you're right. What's that expression? If it were a snake, it would have bit me.
Lucy, please don't insult my intelligence. I know what you're looking for. My medical records. Am I right?
Whoa, hello, my two favorite guys.
Hi, Barbara.
Hey. What are you two doing up so late?
Oh, we're just taking a few laps around the lobby.
In other words, you're going stir crazy in your room upstairs?
Something like that.
Dusty. You two have been batching it up there for days. The only time you ever leave Johnny with me is when you go visit Jennifer's grave. And you know, Jennifer wouldn't want you cooped up all alone with him 24/7. That's not what she would have wanted.
It's okay.
No, it's not.
Screaming, who's out there? You okay? Okay, you're okay. Stay here. Just don't. You're okay. You're with me. You're safe now. You're okay. Okay? Maddie, sweetie, can you tell me what happened?
Somebody tried to kill me.
On a scale from 1 to 10, I'm in the doghouse.
I know that.
And Johnny Boy is doing everything he can to lift my spirits.
Yeah. Two guys roughing it.
Roughing it in a beautiful high rise, yeah.
Full of ghosts and memories.
I can't do anything about missing her.
I think you're wrong about that.
Well, I don't know if I want to even hear about it.
You know, why don't you let me take him?
No, no, it's okay. I got it. I got to get him to bed.
No, no, no. Let me take him.
It's all right.
You get out and do something for yourself, okay? Right?
It's no good without you.
Doesn't have to be good. It just has to be something. Just get out. Hear some music. Take in a movie. Something that takes you out of yourself. Just go to Al's, get a burger, have a malted and make some small talk. Just anything that's not about Jennifer. Do it for Johnny. He doesn't need a father who's all about just him. No child needs an obsessive parent.
You wouldn't know anything about that, would you?
Not a thing. Let me take him. Put him back in his crib where he belongs, and you go out there in the world. Where you belong.
He's cutting a tooth.
I know a little bit about baby teeth. Come on, big boy. Oh, my. Oh. Go on. Get out of here.
I know how ill you are, and how concerned Luke is, but I draw the line at doctor-patient confidentiality.
I see.
If you wanted me to see those files, you would have given them to me.
You disappoint me, Lucy.
Because I wasn't snooping?
A dying man has nothing to hide.
Are you saying you wanted me to see those files?
Let's just say I would have taken as a proof of your concern and growing friendship.
But you're way too smart to be so obvious. No, if you were relying on my natural curiosity or my affection for you, you would have hidden the file better.
Yeah? Why would I do that?
A test. To see if I think you're worth the trouble.
And am I?
You don't have to ask.
Neither do you. So please, not as a professional courtesy, but as a trusted friend, take a look. Tell me if I'm receiving the proper treatment.
I'd be happy to do anything I can to help.
You don't live here anymore. You don't get guest approval. You don't get to ask anyone to leave. In fact, the children aren't here. So really, there's no reason for you to be here either.
Carly, I really do want you to reconsider ending our business partnership. Or you quit. Good. Best decision you could have made.
Well, I don't need your opinion or your approval, Jack. I know how you feel about Simon.
Well, I mean, Simon, even you have to admit you've always been a little shady. The difference is now you're rich and shady. No offense.
No, none taken, Jack. I like being rich.
The bottom line, Jack, is that I get to decide who goes. So, good night. And the next time the alarms go off in this house, the security company will be calling me, not you. Simon.
Yeah?
Would you have a seat, please?
Yeah, I wouldn't get too comfortable. Simon, the only reason she's asking you to stay is to stick it to me.
As usual, Jack, you've got it all wrong. My business dealings with Simon have nothing to do with you. They have to do with me, my survival, my independence, me starting my life over without you. In other words, my business with Simon is no business of yours.
Jack Snyder. Yeah, okay. I'm on my way. I have to get back to work. I'll bring the kids back from Emma's tomorrow.
Awkward. Kali, please, don't quit.
I've really had more than enough for one night. So could you please go, too?
So what, Jack was right, maybe? Maybe you were just using me to stick it to him, as he so delicately put it?
I'm not going to discuss Jack with you. I'm not going to discuss anything with you.
All right, fine. So since every subject is off limits, then let me just dive right in. I knew Katie and Mike were having dinner at the Lakeview tonight, and I did rig dinner with us to make her uncomfortable.
No kidding.
Exactly. Just another thing to add to my long list of childish behavior. But the truth is, Kali, and I can see it with you guys, we are both stuck on our exes. So you come back to work, for me, there is a bonus in it. We can help each other get over our hang-ups. I'll forget Katie, you'll forget Jack, and we'll both be healthy, wealthy, and wise. What do you say?
Hey, long time no see, Mr. Donovan. Pull up here. Bourbon.
Neat.
Hey, I'm sorry to hear about your loss.
Thank you, Russ.
Hey, Pat, are you all right?
You concur with my experts in Malta. There's nothing more to be done.
I'm beyond keeping you comfortable. I'm so sorry.
Thank you, Lucy.
I wish I could offer a better prognosis.
Now, there are unexpected benefits. Living each day as if it were my last. With Luke by my side, I find life amazingly rich.
No, now I really am too keyed up to sleep. I think I'll go out for a while.
You know, I doubt very much you'll be able to sleep either, so if you'll allow me, I'd love to go with you.
Damn it, Jean! Are you nuts?
I'm sorry, I didn't mean to scare you. What are you doing here? I thought you'd be on your way to Gwen by now.
Well, I decided you were right, that I should find Maddie and make her see reason.
What? You were the one who's so positive she's not going to tell your wife we slept together.
Well, I just wanted to make sure. So have you seen her?
No.
Neither have I. What happened to you?
I tripped and I fell.
You're a mess.
Well, you're one to talk. You look like you got into a fight with a mud wrestler. What happened to you?
Better question is, why are the cops here?
Gwen, how you doing?
I'm okay.
Maddie? How is she?
Her vitals are good.
What about these cuts?
Well, they're superficial. I cleaned them up. She's not going to need a stitch. I did give her some diazepam for the shakes.
Maddie, honey, can you tell me what happened? Did you see who did this to you?
It was too dark. I was running.
Running from your attacker?
It was a knife, and it was slashing down at me, cutting me, and I tried to fight, get away, but he shoved me under the water, and I couldn't breathe.
It's okay. You're safe. No one's gonna hurt you, okay?
It's fine. It's all right. It's all right. What happened next? Gwen. Gwen, you pulled me off.
You know, you're creative. Fine. You're doing fine. You're doing fine. Gwen, you want to tell me what you saw?
Just Maddie shooting out of the water, and I heard screaming. I heard shouting before, so I followed the voice down here.
Did you see any other cars in the area?
I came down past Twin Branches. I didn't see anything.
And no one leaving the scene?
No, ma'am.
What were you doing out here so late?
I was looking for Will and Jade.
And even though you don't deserve it, I'm never going to tell anybody that we slept together because I wouldn't want to embarrass you.
Are you going to tell Gwen? Maddie?
No, no, no!
What? Maddie, what is it?
Beats me why the cops are here.
we should check it out.
No, the way that we look, they'd shoot us for swamp creatures.
I'm serious.
No, you're scary. The cops are not here on a picnic. There must be trouble.
Well, that's what I want to find out.
No, that's what you want to stay away from.
Well, what are we supposed to do? Just wait here for the cops to find us? And what's our excuse? We're looking for night crawlers or the real reason to find Maddie and stop her from telling?
Jade and Will? Mention of their name seems to upset you.
I'm really cold.
No, come on. Stay with me for just a minute here, please. Just a minute. What is it about Will and Jade that's got you so scared?
Nothing.
You sure?
When I would be dead if it weren't for you, you saved my life. Thank you.
All right, come on. Come on, let's get back to the attacker. Please.
I told you I don't know anymore, Margo. Please, just, I want to go home.
All right, fine. You should go. You know what? I'm going to call Henry and Eve and have them meet us at the station.
You need me for the ride along?
Yeah, I think Maddie would like that, and we need to get your statement.
Sure.
Yeah, come on.
Dallas, get back to me with anything you find out here. Send a team out into the woods. Call me the minute you find anything.
You're not looking so hot, my friend.
You only like me for my looks?
Well, I'm fickle and life's rough.
Tell me about it.
Yeah. Okay. I brought them. The passport, papers, formally dissolving Jennifer's. Corporate. That's it. Yes, what did you expect, a brass band?
I don't know what I was expecting.
Why don't you let me help you? I'll tell you what you were expecting. You thought this was going to help you move on. And then you saw a girl with long, curly red hair, and it brought it all back.
I'm not good at this moving on stuff.
Who is?
I don't even know what I'm doing here. How's Lily?
Lily's just the same. No change. But, hey, things could be a lot worse, right?
How's the baby?
Baby's great. Healthy. Happy. Home. With Holden.
Well, that's something. House full of kids, isn't it?
Yeah, it's something, yeah. It's something that's threatened, too. Luke thinks he's going to Malta with that pseudo-father of his. I wouldn't trust Damien further than I can throw him.
Real prince, huh?
No, he's a gangster. He's an elegant one, but he's still a gangster. He doesn't care whose life he disrupts. I don't know. He's going to really mess with my family. I don't know what I'm going to do.
Sounds like he's already messed with your family. So what are you going to do about it?
Lucy, tonight I feel like celebrating. See, don't look at me like that. I know death is coming for me, but until it does, I plan to enjoy myself now, shall we?
All right, but you should tell Luke that we're going first.
The boy is fast asleep, I'm sure.
No, I saw his light on when I came down the stairs. Can you tell him?
All right. I'll be right down.
Hi, Holden. It's me. I only have a minute. There's something off about Damien's medical records. They're too perfect. It's like someone looked up a terminal illness and listed all the symptoms, the protocols, the prognosis. I can't prove he's faking. I mean, textbook cases do exist, but this is just too neat. I'm gonna see if I can get a little closer to Damien. Don't worry, I'll be careful. But we need to find out why he's lying or why he lied about this and his reasons for needing Luke in Malta. I gotta go.
Well, you were mistaken about Luke. He's sleeping like an angel. Hmm. Ready to party?
Can't wait.
What is it with you men?
Can I narrow that down a bit?
Yeah, sure. Your egos and these assumptions you make. Like you assuming that I'm playing you off, Jack, because I still have a thing for him.
And it cuts a little bit close to the bone, does it?
God, you are impossible.
Oh, not really. I mean, really, most women find me quite possible.
Oh, Simon, just leave Jack and Katie and any agendas that you have out of this, okay?
Fine. Jack, agendas, Katie, the weather, movies, that's all off limit. That's fine. I tell you what, you tell me right now that you'll come back to work for me, and I'm at the door. We'll call it a night.
can't believe this.
You were having fun, weren't you? New job, new start. And the money was pretty damn good.
That is just so completely not the point.
Well, here is the point, straight up. I need you on this project because I know you'll be brilliant. And I need you to help me open doors that will otherwise be slammed in my face.
Exactly.
But wait, there's more. I need this job to be an unqualified success.
Why? Simon, you hit like the oil jackpot, didn't you? You're a millionaire.
Listen, money in the bank. What? So what? That's boring.
I'd love to be bored like that.
You get what I'm saying, Carly. I know you do. I want something with my brand on it. You know, something that commands respect, something to show for myself. To try to make all these people here, you know, forget all my other misdeeds and misadventures. Oh, and just by the by, I don't mind if you don't mind me asking, how many hits have you had on your interior design website? That many, huh? So what's stopping you, Carly? Come on, go all in with me. Let's make every single person in this town sit up and take notice. Prove to everyone, Jack and Katie included, that we have got the stuff to make it on our own, and who the hell needs them?
You know, I really have to hand it to you, Simon. You could sell hot sauce in hell.
Well, even the devil needs a little flavor. Come on, are we back on?
You know, you say the right things. The problem is that, you know, tonight I promised my kids a mom night all to themselves with movies and popcorn and books, and then you called me and I dropped everything at the drop of a hat. And I left them with a babysitter that I don't even know. Just so you could parade me around in front of Katie and Mike, who happened to be my friends. And Simon, I don't have any interest in being any part of hurting them.
You won't.
Just let me finish, okay? It's been difficult for me to admit what I have known in my heart all along. But this is it. Simon Fraser. You are nothing but trouble.
So, just taking a wild stab in the dark here. I guess that business trip to New York's off. No? With my flying done what?
Are you telling me that after that great, big, fat farce of a business meeting, the trip to New York was legit? You really need me to wow potential investors?
Yeah. See, yeah. All right. Believe it or not, that bit was real. So, are we on?
No.
Why not?
No, we are definitely off.
Come on, come with me. We'll take New York by storm.
No, the answer is definitely no.
Oh, listen, you'll have those hot shots eating out of your hand. And then afterwards, we'll celebrate our success. We'll go to the best restaurants. We'll drink the finest wines. Katie, Mike and Jack will be miles away, and best of all, you and I will be having fun, which, you know, and that's my opinion, but I think we did establish that you needed a little bit of this fun.
I didn't ask your opinion.
I heard Jack say that the kids are still with Emma. Now, I have a jet on the runway, fueled and waiting, champagne's on ice. Come on, a moonlit flight to the greatest city in the world. It's yours for the taking.
Simon, have a safe trip.
Wow. I really did blow it, didn't I? Wow, I am sorry.
Goodbye.
You know, it's a shame. It is a shame, because, you could have made quite a formidable team.
Yeah, you're right. I think we could have.
Okay. Oh,
Holden and I have been working in tandem to try to check Damien. But that in itself has its unique hazards.
Like what? What hazards?
Well, speak of the devil.
Lucy's with Damien?
You don't want to know. Well, fine company you're keeping, young lady.
I'm being followed by my grandmother.
You are going to follow me, dear. You're going to follow me right out of this place and into my car and home.
I moved out. It's obvious you have no respect for me or my opinions.
No, this is your kind of place. You want to join us for a game?
Why don't you stop all this nonsense? Stop it. Stop the nonsense and come home where you belong.
I've already found a place to live. You can have my mail forwarded to Damien's.
Oh, you cannot be serious, dear.
I like it there. I've been made to feel welcome. Would you excuse us, Grandmother? We're going to play pool.
My business is completed. I'm out of here.
Oh, what's going on? Yeah. Hey.
Sorry about that.
Lucinda? I adore her. She's like a grand opera in the old tradition.
Yep. I have a confession to make.
Tell me, my child.
I don't know how to play this game.
I have a feeling you'll catch on quite quickly.
Show me.
It'll be my pleasure. All right. Leaning to the table. Let me be your teacher. Love you, cute. Thanks. Yes. Relax into me. Okay. And now you strike the ball with a cue. All right.
Hi, Henry, Eve. Can I have a few moments alone with Maddie?
I hope we can count on you to treat her better than you have in the past. I'm going to be very careful with her. I promise you.
Thank you. Come on. Come on.
Honey, here, I brought you some hot cocoa, and you can have it later, okay? All right, why don't we just pick up where we left off? You want to try as much as you can to describe your attacker to me? Was he tall, short, heavy, thin, facial hair?
No, I told you, I don't even know. I couldn't even tell if it was a man or a woman.
All right, that's fine, that's fine. Can you describe to me what your attacker was wearing?
Why do you keep calling him an attacker? He's a killer. He tried to kill me.
And thank God he didn't succeed. All right, honey, just talk to me. Let's go back to the clothing.
I just saw gloves.
That's good. What color?
Dark. And I guess I saw sweatshirt, pants, all dark.
I'm sorry. It's okay. You're remembering. It's good.
All I remember is the killer coming after me and coming after me and then they're stabbing at me over and over again.
It's all right. Shh. It's okay.
Is it okay if I come in?
Yeah, sure.
Can I go home?
No, not yet. You just relax.
If you didn't get a good look at the killer, the police are gonna have plenty of...
Well, I don't even know if it was the killer. The same psycho that killed Leah or Nate.
Wait, what do you mean?
I don't know. I think it was somebody else coming after me.
Now that Maddie was viciously attacked, you know what we've known all along. She is not a serial killer.
We'd like to take her home now.
I'd really like to detain Maddie for a while longer.
Detain? Margo?
This is outrageous. She is a victim here.
I won't keep her long, I promise. I just want to give her some time to collect her thoughts, and I'm going to check with CSU, and then I need to ask her a few more questions.
What was that all about? You're holding Maddie Coleman?
You know what? I got to talk with Dallas at the crime scene, and then I can tell you more.
Where did you two come from?
The woods. What's going on?
Watch your step. This is a crime scene.
What happened?
Maddie Coleman was attacked here tonight.
Oh, my God.
Is she okay? A little shaken up, but she sustained some cuts inflicted by a knife.
Slasher.
That's one possibility. Your wife found Maddie in the water, hysterical.
Is Gwen okay?
Look, she's fine.
Okay, so where are they now?
At the station.
When did this happen?
At least an hour ago. Look, did any of you hear or see anything?
No.
No, nothing. Okay, I'm going to need you guys to come down to the station and give a statement.
Yes, first thing in the morning.
No, now works for me. Unless you've got a problem with that.
Maddie, of course, it was the slasher. Look at your arms. Who else could it have been? Someone who wants me to keep my mouth shut? Like who? What were you doing in the woods, anyway? What? Why were you looking for Will and Jade?
I was actually just looking more for Will.
Why?
It was something Will's mom said. It sounds girly paranoid now. She was warning me about Jade, how she might make a move on Will. What does that have to do with what's going on?
I think one of them tried to kill me because of their secret.
Well, one of who? Maddie, who are you talking about?
Will and Jade.
You know, I hate to sound like a quitter, but I don't think pool is my game.
What are you talking about? You did great. Don't be so hard on yourself. Mm. Besides, it takes time to find what you're really good at. And you, sweet Lucy, you have nothing but time.
How soon are you planning to take Luke back to Malta?
The arrangements are being made within the week.
Does it have to be so soon?
What do you ask? Is it too much to hope that you will miss me?
Of course I will.
Lucy, I want you to know that you're welcome to stay at Fairwinds for as long as you like.
I'm not worried about that.
None of this is easy for me. I hate separating Luke from his family right now. At first, I forbade him, and Luke insisted on coming home with me.
Well, you share a very special bond.
You understand that?
Of course I do. But if you don't mind my asking, why did you wait to tell Luke how sick you are?
If I had my way, I never would have found out until it was over.
But why? I mean, you two are so close. If you had told him, say, in the beginning of summer, you could have taken the trip to Malta then and had so much more time together.
And if I told you early, perhaps you and I could have had some time together as well. No?
We're together now. Why ask for more? I need a refill.
I'll take care of it right away.
Oh, no, no, no. I insisted. This round's on me.
All right, then.
Got a question for you. What are you doing hanging out with a sleazy guy like Damien Grimaldi?
Cleared for takeoff. And I'm sorry to report I will be flying solo tonight.
Miss Gwen, I want to see my wife.
Look, wait here. Right. Hey. I found those two out by the crime scene. I brought them in for question.
You think they know anything?
Psst, not the head I'm telling.
Did you find anything out there?
A few scraps of Maddie's clothes. Nothing to really help us ID the slasher.
You're working something here, Monica. What is it?
Maddie's wounds were superficial. And there's no real evidence at the crime scene other than Maddie's own torn clothes. And she claims to have this hazy recollection of her attacker. And Gwen Munson didn't see anyone. So given all that, how can I let her go, Jack?
So obviously you're thinking...
Well, maybe in order to keep us from tagging her for the other two murders, she's made herself the victim.
You really think she did this herself?
Can't rule it out.
Look, Maddie, with everything that went down tonight, it's no wonder you're confused, but you can't actually believe that Will or Jade tried to kill you.
I don't know. I don't know. It all mixed up in my head. I saw them.
Well, yeah.
And I saw them before I was attacked.
Okay, but what do they have to do with whoever attacked you?
I heard them talking, and they wanted me to keep my mouth shut.
About what?
About the night that they slept together.